Hey, what's up, guys? You know, recently I was watching the unboxing of the new 27-inch iMac, and it kind of got me thinking, I wonder what it would have been like if YouTube tech reviewers had been around during the early days of personal computing. You know, like, what would it have been like to see John Furlakers in the 80s reviewing the first color monitor? Or maybe Soldier Knows Best in 1984 talking about the release of the first Macintosh. It'd been really cool. It kind of makes me wish I could invent a time machine. Who are you?
I'm you, from the future.
So I did invent a time machine?
No, of course not, dumbass. But in OS 10.22, time machine backup actually allows you to travel in time.
But I'm here to give you an important mission. You must travel back in time and review the tech products of yesteryear. The fate of the world depends upon it.
The fate of the world? Really?
No, not really, dude. But it's gonna be awesome.
Sweet.
Where am I?
An official Macintosh?
Awesome! Let's review it!
Let's start by looking at the design of it. Now, while the Mac was being built, Steve Jobs specifically said he wanted the case to look timeless, and I think that's something that they achieved, since really the Macintosh has a unique look even to this day, and especially when you compare it against computers of its time, such as the IBM 5150, it really stands out. Now, the original Macintosh is, of course, an all-in-one system, much like the iMac of today, where the display and all the components are all inside one case. Another feature of the design is this integrated carrying handle on the top. What's funny is that this computer was actually considered portable for its day, being so light and compact, and two of my favorite pictures from the manual actually illustrate that. For user input, the Macintosh, of course, uses a keyboard, and then what was somewhat revolutionary for the time, a mouse for its graphic user interface. The keyboard actually connects to the front of the Mac using a connector that most people associate now with a landline telephone. Speaking of the mouse, it of course is a single button like Apple stuck with for years, and it connects the computer through a serial style port in the back of the Mac. Also on the back you have connectors for other types of peripherals such as a printer or even a 1984 style modem. Now for what everyone wants to see, let's go ahead and fire this sucker up. It actually boots fairly quickly, and once it reads the disk, you'll get a familiar looking Finder smiley face, and then a very friendly Welcome to Macintosh dialog box pops up before it actually launches Finder. The graphic user interface of the original Macintosh is one of the reasons it really stood out. It was one of the first computers to take that interface and really bring it into the home, so people weren't just using boring command line style things like you see in Terminal or MS-DOS. Now, one of the things that I find pretty surprising about using OS System 1 is how similar it is to OS 10. I think you could actually take someone from 1984 who'd used the Macintosh, put them in front of a Snow Leopard computer, and they'd be able to find their way around pretty easy. Another feature that matches the Macs of today is the lack of a physical eject button for the disk. You have to eject it using the software. So I guess Steve Jobs' war on buttons actually started pretty early on. Speaking of the disk drive, one way this machine really stands out from the Macs today is that there is no internal hard drive. For storage, you have to use a floppy disk, and that's actually how it boots its operating system and then just runs it off of the RAM.
Well, guys, what did we learn by looking at the original Macintosh today? Well, for me, the big thing to take away from it is that there's actually not that much difference between this Mac and the Mac and PCs that me and you use today. In fact, I would argue that the real revolution in home computing happened in 1984 when this machine was released. If you look at the home computers that came before it, a lot of command line style interfaces, not only that great of design, they're really built by scientists and engineers for other scientists and engineers. And this was really built from the ground up with the general public in mind. Everything from that operating system, which is really the basis of all the operating systems we use today, to a good hardware design with an excellent human interface that made it accessible to everyone out there. And that is really why the original Macintosh is a classic of home computers.
Oh, where am I now?
Cat the ray tube?
Oh no!
I'm in the 90s!